If you like low-calorie cola drinks, and I definitely do, I drink 2 litres of Diet Coke a day.
What?
2 litres?
Yeah, I do. It's awful.
I am trying to curb her of
this really
habit.
Is, yeah. It's a problem. We've got some important information that everyone should know. Health coach Leanne Hall is with us now, and Leanne, I'm doing it wrong. I started obviously drinking Diet Coke because I thought it was good for me, but it actually could be making me fat.
Well, there is research that suggests that, and that's because of the artificial sweeteners that are in the Diet Coke, and it's also very, very acidic as well, so it can wreak havoc with your metabolism and also with your insulin levels as well. So overall, the news isn't good for weight loss and diet sodas at all.
Mm. And also there's an issue, especially with young children, drinking these high-energy caffeinated drinks, which I don't think a lot of people realise how damaging they are.
No, well, look, caffeine is a psychoactive drug, and I think we forget that. A little bit of caffeine is completely fine, but if you're a young person and you're having loads of soft drinks, and particularly those energy drinks, which can have up to 2 shots of coffee in any one drink, so what that's doing to their brain chemistry as well, it increases your natural stimulants like dopamine, so it's actually just not good for your brain chemistry.
Isn't excessive caffeine also perhaps detrimental to your bone health?
It is, and that comes from the idea that caffeine does leach calcium from your bones, but to put it into perspective, there's around 80 grams of, you know, say coffee in a shot, and that will leach around 6 milligrams of calcium from your bones. And we need about 1,000 to 1,200 milligrams of calcium a day, so you need to be drinking a lot of coffee and having a lot of caffeine to have that effect on your bone density.
Okay, wow. We've actually got some graphics to talk to about some good sources of calcium in our diet as well. So dairy foods, of course, are great, but a lot of people have allergies to those as well. So what else can we... cheese, yogurt, milk, obviously. Yeah. What else can we look at?
Look, calcium's also found in leafy greens as well, beans and legumes, and also canned fish and just fish in general contains a lot of calcium. And even things like chia seeds and some grains and nuts as well contain high levels of calcium. So traditionally we get most of our calcium from animal-based products, which is the dairy and things like that. But increasingly there's a number of plant-based foods that contain loads of calcium.
Okay. All right, and just back to the diet drinks. I mean, what is a safe level? Because I started drinking Diet Coke, geez, back when I was a teenager because my stepfather had diabetes.
Yep.
And that's what we used to drink as a treat. And then it's just something, you know, that's hung around. So I've been doing it for maybe, 20 years.
Yeah. And 2 litres a day, I guess that's quite a lot. And you wouldn't want to be cutting it out completely, would you? So you'd probably just kind of start by gradually decreasing it. Look, one a day isn't going to hurt. It's the same with coffee. I mean, I'd die without my coffee. Yeah, absolutely. A couple of coffees a day, a Diet Coke a day. You know, you're not doing yourself any, you know, huge disservice there. But any more than that, 8 cups of coffee a day, 9 cups, 2 litres of Coke, too much of anything, I think, can
moderation.
Be good.
Yeah. That old chestnut.
You should just do shots. A play of shots.
Or maybe water. Actually, I actually read that perhaps drinking, you know, you can buy the carbonated waters as well.
Yeah.
That gives you the feeling of the bubbles. Yeah, without... Yeah.
Champagne does that too.
Yes. Ooh, indeed. Well, Leanne Hall, thank you very much for coming in and explaining that to us. Much appreciated. Craig Bennett cracks open the Showbiz File after this. Don't miss it. You're watching Studio 10.